Suppose let us consider there is a another. This is the resistance R1, this is the resistance R2, this is the resistance R3, and this is the resistance R4. Through the current, through the resistance, I1 is current, through the resistance, I2 is coming, through the resistance R3, I3 is coming, I1 is coming to here, I2 is coming to here, I3 is coming to here. All the currents are going to meet at the point A, then the total current is said to be I4. Now here R1, R2, R3, R4 resistors are connected like this. R1, R2, R3, R4 resistors are connected like this. Here incoming current I, as it reaches the point B, it is going to divide I1, I2, I3. Therefore, the point here, the currents are going to divide. This point is called, what to say, junction. Junction. Here I1 current, I2 current, I3 current. These three currents are going to combine. After combining, the resultant current is I4. Therefore, this is the point where the currents are going to meet. This is the point where the currents are going to divide. This is the point where the currents are going to combine. Again, this is also called current junction. Here the currents are going to divide. Here the currents are going to combine. Here this is a junction and this is a junction. Therefore, here the point B is a junction. Here the point A is a junction. Therefore, what is the junction? The point where the currents are going to divide, the point where the currents are going to combine is called junction. Right now, once you know the junction, what is the statement? What is the statement of Kirchhoff junction law? Kirchhoff junction law. Right, Kirchhoff junction law, Kirchhoff current law is also known as Kirchhoff junction law. Kirchhoff junction law. What is the statement of Kirchhoff junction law? The algebraic sum of currents at a junction is equals to zero. Algebraic sum of currents at a junction is equals to zero. Algebraic, this is the symbol. Currents, this is called I, is equals to, what do you say, zero. Algebraic sum of currents at a junction is equals to zero. Whenever the term algebraic, whenever the term algebraic, there is a need of sign convention. What is the sign convention? The currents towards the junction is taken as positive. The currents away from the junction are taken as negative. Whenever the term algebraic is used, there is a sign convention. There is a sign convention. What is the sign convention? The currents towards the junction are taken as positive. The currents away from the junction are taken as negative. Therefore, here, now, once I will apply an example. Now, let us consider this is a resistor. Now, this is another resistor. This is another resistor. This is another resistor. There is a current I1, there is a current that is I2, here there is a current I3, here there is a current I4. Now current I1 is coming to this point, current I2 is coming to this point, current I3 is away from the point, current I4 is also away from the point. What is the junction? Let us consider this is the junction. At the junction, see how many number of currents, I1, I2, I3, and I4. How many currents are there? How many currents are there? That is I1, next current I2, next current I3, next current I4 is equals to, what to say, 0. According to the sign convention, concentrate at a junction. The current I1 is towards the junction, therefore it is taken as positive. The current I2 is also towards the junction, is taken as, what to say, positive. The current I3 is away from the junction A, therefore it is taken as negative. The current I4, again away from the junction, it is also taken as minus. Therefore, if you simplify, I1 plus I2 is equals to I3 plus I4. Now see, this is the sum of currents. Here is also, this is the sum of currents. This is the sum of currents towards the junction. This is the sum of currents away from the junction. According to the Kirchhoff first law, according to the Kirchhoff current law, according to the Kirchhoff junction law, the sum of currents towards the junction is equals to the sum of currents away from the junction. The sum of currents towards the junction is equals to the sum of currents away from the junction. Whatever the total current coming towards the junction is equals to the total current away from the junction. Therefore, at the junction, there is no accumulation of the charge. Current, the sum of currents towards the junction is equals to the sum of currents away from the junction. Whatever the current coming towards the junction, the total current is away from the junction. Therefore, at the junction, there is no accumulation of the charge. There is no storage of the charge. Therefore, this is according to the conservation of energy. This is according to the conservation of energy. That is, inward charge, inward amount of the charge is equals to the outward amount of the charge. Therefore, Kirchhoff current law is also known as Kirchhoff junction law. It should be applied at a junction. What is the statement? The algebraic sum of currents at a junction is equals to 0. It is purely applicable for a junction. It is according to the conservation of the charge. Right? Let us consider. That is, there is an example. Right? These are the resistors. Four resistors are arranged like this, through which I1, I2, I3, I4 are arranged like this. I1, I2, I3, I4. I1, that is, this is towards the junction, is taken as positive. I2 is towards the junction, is taken as positive. And I3 is away from the junction, minus. I4 is also away from the junction, minus. Therefore, equals to 0. Therefore, this is called algebraic sum. Now, if you simplify this equation, I1 plus I2 is equals to I3 plus I4. Therefore, this is called sum of the currents towards the junction. Now this is called sum of the currents away from the junction. According to the Kirchhoff first law, the sum of currents towards the junction is equals to the sum of currents away from the junction. Now I will tell you another example. Right, numerical example. Example number 2. Right. Now there is a current. There is a resistor. Now there is a resistor. Now there is a resistor. What is the current? Let us consider 10 amps. Right, let us consider, that is, what to say, 5 amps. Right, what is the current here? Now let us consider, this is the resistance R1, this is the resistance R2, this is the resistance R3. Right, now what is the current through the resistance R3? Let us consider, what is the current? Let us consider I. Therefore, 10 amps of current, 5 amps of current, and current I. Algebraic sum is equals to 0. 10 amps towards the junction, positive. 5 amps towards the junction is also positive. And let us consider, this is also positive. Therefore, 10 plus 5, that is 15, plus I is equals to 0. Therefore, I is equals to minus 15 amps. Therefore, through the resistor, what is the current? 15 amps. As there is a negative, that current is away from the junction. Therefore, this is a numerical example of your Kirchhoff first law. Right, next one. What is the Kirchhoff second law?